I can't even say these words.
They're creative.
Yes.
Yeah, that's one way to put it.
Well, adjusting to a new school is tough on children at this age, at any age, really, and I don't want to minimize that. But is there anything else going on that we should be aware of?
Oh, I wouldn't even know where to start.
How about his father?
Well, I don't want to take up all your time.
We have loads of time.
We're in the middle of a divorce. Oliver's father was having an affair with his assistant and our accountant and my hairdresser while she was still doing my hair, so that was fun. And now he's filed for custody of Oliver, full custody, and he won't pay any support until he gets what he wants. Plus, he's a lawyer.
Shit.
So I just had to get out of there as fast as I could, and I took Oliver with me, and I got a job at Mission Hills. I'm a CAT scan tech, so I just see really rough stuff all day. You know, cancer and tumors and cysts and clots, and I see what I'm looking at, but I can't tell, you know, the people that are laying there, so that's miserable all day, and I work really late because I'm trying to get our act together. That's why he's here, so he can have a good education, and I'm trying to just give him a semi-normal life, and I'm dealing with this shit from David and custody. I'm sorry about swearing. I know he didn't even want kids. He didn't want them. He's just doing this so I'm not happy. You know Oliver's adopted. Did you know that?
I don't know
how you would, but he is. And I cannot have kids. You know, something about my fallopian tubes being twisted. I think, what I really think, is that they were just recoiling from David's sperm. Can I just have one thank you? Thank you for that. So I just think that all of this has kind of permeated, you know, Oliver's whole little being, right? I mean, it has to, it's like a little sponge.